Welcome to my channel, detailing events throughout history. 1944. Hartford Circus Fire. In the days, circuses would travel into towns to perform. They performed under huge canvas tents, which we know as big tops. On July 6, 1944, thousands of people made their way to Barber Street, Hartford, Connecticut to see the Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey Circus perform. Around 8,000 people were attending at the time. The Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey Circus was the largest in the country. The Big Top could hold up to 9,000 spectators around three giant rings. The Big Top had been coated in 1,800 pounds of paraffin wax, which was dissolved in 6,000 gallons of gasoline. This was a very common form at the time of making these tents weatherproof. The circus first traveled to Hartford on July 5, 1944. At the time they were behind schedule, so one show was cancelled. It was considered by circus personnel to be very bad luck to miss a show. The show began in the afternoon of July 6. Thousands packed into the Big Top. The fire began as a small flame on the southwest side of the tent. The circus band leader was the first to spot the flames, and quickly instructed the band to play the Stars and Stripes Forever tune, which was a signal to other circus personnel that something was wrong. The ringmaster urged spectators not to panic, and to leave the tent in an orderly fashion. However, the power had failed and no one in the Big Top could hear his instructions. The crowds began to panic when they saw the flames, which were quickly spreading. People frantically ran about looking for their loved ones, who they had been separated from in the panic. Some spectators who had made it out of the tent, went back inside looking for their family members. Other spectators decided to remain in their seats, assuming that someone would come and put out the fire. By the time they realized what was happening, it was too late for them. Two of the exits had been blocked by chutes, used for bringing the big cats in and out of the tent. Because of the weatherproof coating on the tent, flames spread rapidly. Melting paraffin wax poured down on those spectators below. The tent collapsed around 8 minutes after the fire had started, trapping all those left inside. Many people burned to death, while others died as a result of the chaos inside the tent. It was believed that the heat from the fire, along with the paraffin and gasoline, would have incinerated those inside, much like a cremation. Some people jumped from the top of the bleachers to try and escape. Others were trampled to death, and some asphyxiated under the piles of people falling over one another to get out. Most of the bodies found were in piles. However, some survived under the piles of bodies, as they were protected against the fire. It was stated that 168 people had died in the fire, but it is believed that this figure could be much higher, as some remains were not identified. Those who had survived the fire were left with physical and emotional scars. It was thought that around 700 people were injured. The circus accepted full responsibility for the damages, but not for the disaster itself. On July 7, involuntary manslaughter charges were filed against 5 members of the circus. In the end, the circus paid out $5 million to 600 victims, who had filed claims against them. What caused the fire still remains unsolved. Investigations into the fire, believed it could have been started by a cigarette being discarded, but arson was not ruled out. Several years later, Robert Dale Segee confessed to starting the fire. However, later on he recanted his confession. In 2002, the Hartford Circus Fire Memorial Foundation was established. A memorial was erected at the site of where the fire had been. Several bronze plaques describe what happened at certain times during the fire. The central plaque sits exactly where the center ring of the Big Top had been that afternoon. Names of all those who died is listed on this plaque. Whatever the cause of the fire had been, it had an enormous impact on circuses. New regulations were introduced, stating that circus tents had to be fireproof as opposed to waterproof. Smoking would no longer be permitted inside cloth, temporary structures. Trained fire personnel needed to be in attendance at all times, and no exits could ever be blocked. Ringling Brothers and Barnum & Bailey performed for the last time in 1956, using their iconic outdoor big top. From then on, they would continue to perform in buildings and arenas only. It was one of the deadliest fires in circus history. Thank you for watching and learning about events throughout the decades. Forever remembering those who perished on that fateful afternoon. May your memory live on.